Well, I'm going to re-record the video called Astrology's Higher Revelation because I used the YouTube upload webcam and it's cutting out on the volume. So, basically, at its root, what I was saying is that astrology is the study of the stars, and if we're allowing the stars to predict what's going to happen in our lives, then we are putting ourselves under the jurisdiction of creation, which would be the jurisdiction of man, rather than being the creator, which is the power of thought. Now, the reason why I say this is because I'm doing a study on astrology right now. And I've been listening to the top astrology teacher on YouTube. And he says that that the stars will tell us everything that we need to know about life. And I'm here to say that the stars and everything in astrology, all the books that have been written by the Illuminati, all that astrological information is all female. And if we are using the female's information to live our life, then we're not operating in the full capacity of the law of attraction. Because the law of attraction says that we have the power with our thoughts to create our own realities. Although everything that the Illuminati has revealed and all the astrological books that have been written, which have debunked the fictional Jesus story, which I agree with, all that astrological illuminated information is limited. And I'll give an example. I've been doing YouTube searches on zodiac astrologers who give horoscopes. And, you know, individual horoscopes. And they'll give, some will give horoscopes on a grander scale, such as national horoscopes, to where a national horoscope is the astrologer will take in account the birth of a nation, and they'll be able to predict things that are going to happen in that nation according to that nation's astrological horoscope. And those horoscopes have to do with the interpretation of the position of the planets in the zodiacal belt. And they can tell when certain planets are bringing forth bad things to happen in the country. And I listened to one top national zodiac astrologer who gives a horoscope for a country. In other words, she's able to go on in the public, on public TV or public YouTube videos, and say this and this and this is going to happen within the country. Such as there'll be a change of leaderships, there'll be great earthquakes, different bad things will happen. So the astrologer will say both good and bad will happen. From my studies of the law of attraction, if we speak bad things to happen in our lives, then our expectation is going to attract bad things to happen in our nations. All because we've listened to all the popular interpretations of the stars, known as astrology, which have been brought to us by the Illuminati, ancient of knowledge, which is the top knowledge of the universe. But I'm here to say that the Illuminati ancient knowledge has a higher level, and that is this. Power of our thoughts, if when we're reading the astrological horoscopes we see bad things are going to happen because of the planetary alignments, then with the power of our thoughts we are now the creator who has the law of cause and effect on our side, to where we can cause creation to have a good outcome all the time. So that if the stars are telling us that bad things are on the horizon, whether it be day-to-day individual horoscopes, where the horoscope astrologer will get on the YouTube and they'll say, be careful of this, this, and this, because there are some bad things in your path today. We can say, oh no, I'm the creator. I'm the male. I'm the spirit. I have the power of influence on the female, which is the horoscope that's just been interpreted from the stars. Because stars are just creation. Stars are just female. All the planets are just female. And they were brought into existence by the male, which is the power of thought, the invisible realm, which is the spirit. So, if we see bad things that are going to happen in the zodiac astrology horoscopes, then we have the power to say, oh, whoa. If terrorism and piracy is being predicted in the stars, we can say, oh no, we're going to rehabilitate that piracy and that terrorism with the power of our thoughts. We're going to bring it into balance. Now, let's take that to another level. That would be called the unlimited thinking capacity. Now, let's talk about that as far as being a secure party creditor. When we're a secure party creditor, if we're still paying for stuff with another nation's currency, then we are not fully free yet. Although we're on our way to freedom. But until such time as we create our own currency and pay for stuff with our own currency, our own national currency, as secure party creditor, until we do that, we're not operating fully in the capacity of a secure party creditor. And so the universe cannot attract to us the higher levels to operate in, because we are still operating in a lower level. And so when we operate in that lower level, we attract everything at a lower level in our lives. But there's nothing wrong with moving up in the position of the universe. It's a good thing. So if you are a secure party creditor and you're still using some other nation's currency to pay for your stuff, even though you don't work a job and you're self-employed, self-employment is just one step above higher than having a job. And not working at all is a step above self-employment. That's where I am. I haven't worked a job and I haven't been self-employed for the past 2 years. I do absolutely nothing except share information on YouTube. That's all I do. So that's a higher position than self-employment. And I say this because there's some people out there that need to have that goal set for them so they can reach toward it. Everyone in his own time. So there's no finger pointing, there's no blame. I'm just the one that's here to say, hey, here's the next level. Let's shoot for that. Now, you can create your own money. And if you get dishonored, if your money gets dishonored, then you send it to the IRS, the CID. Criminal Investigation Division of your country. Every country has an IRS. It might be called a different name. Every country has an IRS. And every IRS corporation has a Criminal Investigation Division. So you just send copies of all your dishonors to the CID. Until you get results. And that's what I'm doing right now. I've lived without cash for the past 2 years. Although every now and then I get some cash money through different avenues. But for the most part, I've learned how to live without cash. I hold title to this house. I hold title to this property. I've learned to live without utilities, without water, to live off the rainwater, to get free food bank food, free showers in the city, free toothpaste, free soap from the Pope, known as Catholic Community Services. And the reason that the Pope gives all this stuff out free is because he understands that if he doesn't, Mother Nature will snuff him out in a heartbeat. That's the only reason he gives a little bit of free stuff to the people. Because Mother Nature honors that lean position when people put that lean position in. And enough people have put that lean position in the past, and the church has gone through their experiences of not giving people at least a little something free, enough to survive on. Because people can survive off rainwater. They can survive off food bank food. I've proven it to myself it can be done. And they know it can be done. You just got to train yourself to do it. We really don't need all this food they sell in the supermarket. Food bank food, you can live off food bank food. It can be done. In fact, the Pope knows that we have the power of our mind to be able to live off no food. They know this. So they know it can be done. So if you're struggling with your use of food and training yourself in the body, then it's your own fault. And the Pope knows this. Because the Pope knows that you are only answerable to the universe. And if the universe is backing up the Pope's decision to only give you just enough food to survive and say, hey, go get some rainwater, and if the universe has backed that up, and the evidence of backing that up is the fact that the universe has not taken out the Pope. So everything comes back to the universe. If the systems that are in place are still here and operating at some type of level, functioning, then you know the universe is backing it up. So as a side note, there's your answer to never point the finger at anybody, to never raise your voice at anybody, to be in complete harmony with everyone, because you understand that they're not doing it. It's the universe that's given us the little tiny bit to survive off, because the universe loves us just enough to give us enough to survive off of, because the universe wants us to finally get to a point and say, well, I want more than just to be able to survive. I want to thrive. So the universe says, okay, now with your secured party creditor position, start creating your own money. If you have to, just start with one bill. I mean, not one bill, but start with one bank. Open up a separate bank account that's going to be just for creating your own money. Start writing checks, trust checks on that bank account. Or write your own promissory notes and send it over the counter, or send it privately to the corporation. But the easy way to do it that I found is just to use bank checks. Just turn them into a trust check. Sign it as trustee, endorse it on the back as beneficiary. The printed name on the front is already grantor. Grantor, trustee, beneficiary. and then just start experimenting. Send to the bank until you get to the point where you feel confident to write checks that are more than what's in your bank account. And then when the bank draws you into the negative, then send all that information, copies of all the dishonors from the bank, to the CID. And see what happens. And that's what I'm doing right now. But I guarantee you, it's going to go through. Now, there might have to be some adjustments being made, but realize mostly the adjustments are in your thoughts, the power of your thoughts. So if you're a secure party creditor and, you know, you're at a certain level and you're happy with your level, you're self-employed and all that, but you're still using another nation's currency to provide for yourself, well, then you're legally still putting yourself under that nation's jurisdiction. In the eyes of the universe. In other words, you're not fully operating in the full capacity of your universal trust yet. And so if you're not operating in the full capacity of your universal trust yet, then your eternal life is not secure. That means that sickness, illness, death still has an opening to collect from you. But no need to worry. Because if you die, it's all right. You'll just forget who you are and recycle. If you're ready to die and leave your memories and your body behind, and your precious life behind, and your children and your families, if you're willing to leave them behind, it's up to you. But if you still got plenty of years left in your life to move up to the next level, well, then there's no hurry. If you think you can do it in the next 50 years and get that done, well, cool. I'm just saying, if you don't get it done and you die or you get sick and all that other good stuff, now you know. I'm not here to point a finger at you to blame you and say, I'm just saying, hey man, this is the higher level of understanding beyond all the top astrologers, the Illuminati astrologers. Beyond all the top secured party creditors on the earth that have not yet told you this information publicly, I'm the first one to do it. Don't feel bad and sad in your position if you aren't at that level yet.
just be real with yourself. You know, if you can, and say, and see if there's some sense in it for you. I figure if there's some sense in it for me, then there's sense in it for everybody to be held. But once we start getting a taste, once I get a taste, or whoever, but once that taste is held, is tasted, and we're able to be honored, we're honored by the universe. We're not honored by man. Universe is just honoring our intentions through the power of thought. Once the universe honors us for our money that we've created, then at that point, we can teach all the rest of society, or those that are open to it, the same process, and then gain the upper hand over the money system, and we can slowly but surely get rid of the money system and just live straight off the land with Mother Nature and share one another's talents. Some people know how to grow food. Some people know how to build houses. Some people know how to entertain. The three fundamentals of life: food, shelter, entertainment. Food because we're hungry, shelter because it's cold, entertainment because it's boring. And then there's another level after that. And that's the level of the option of food, the option of shelter, the option of entertainment. Where our bodies will be vibrating at such a high level, it will not be required to have food, will not be required to have shelter, it will not be required to have entertainment. We will be self-contained units within ourselves, with the ability to do anything we want, morph into anything we want, into any body, travel anywhere in the universe we want. Perform anything that we want. All through the power of thought, which is the creator, which has the influence of cause over the body or the stars, the universe. Affect the universe in the way that we desire. Our thoughts desire. Our thoughts desire total fulfillment, everything going good all the time, everything easy, comfortable, relaxed, taking our time. Nothing bad happening, everything good happening. And if we see something bad that might happen, then we use the power of our thoughts to turn it around so that it becomes good. Because that is what you call a state of total prosperity and health. No sickness, no illness, nothing bad happening. So, like I said, I am a what's called the revolutionary for all representative for all of mankind that have been on this planet, and all the spirits that are out there awaiting their bodies, their eternal bodies. I'm the pivotal point. Because I'm the first man on this earth that has both a dual capacity function, because I hold knowledge in the two most important subjects of the universe, and that's Secure Party Creditor and astrology. Although I am not an expert in astrology, and I'm still working on explaining and learning everything, but I understand the principles that underlie all the explanations that are being spoken on the internet, on YouTube, by the top astrologer teachers that are there. I understand the principles that are higher information than what these top astrologers are teaching. Reason being is because I was created that way. It's just who I am. And I know who I am. I've never lived a past life. I am what's called a virgin life. I'm the first one in the evolution of mankind that was born virgin. Virgin holding an unlimited capacity of knowledge. So I don't have a lot of those old past lives habits to weigh me down. I am the first life form of this kind out of everyone that's been born. Someone's got to do it. It's got to come from somewhere. And it just happened to be me. I am the only one on this planet and on YouTube as a secure party creditor that has experienced everything that the district county attorney throw at a person. And I purposely put myself in that position to test it, to be able to know it, and to stand and say, hey, it can be done. There is no secure party creditor on YouTube that can speak the words that I speak to you today. Not even my teachers can say what I say today. I have accomplished that beyond my teachers. Because that's the way I was created. That's just a part of me, who I am. I take everything to the furthest extreme possible and put it to the test, to the ultimate test. Like I said, I owed 12 banks $130,000. And they got the courts to try to collect from me, and the courts put in their own court judgments against me. And then they sent letters in the mail that said, now pay up because we have court judgments against you. And I saw right through the bluff and just said, oh, that's just a test of the universe. They're just testing me to see if I'll put myself back under the jurisdiction of man, or will I trust in myself? Will I trust in all the spirits that are awaiting their bodies to intercede on my behalf? Face the banks, the courts, the state tax, IRS tax, and the county property tax. And the utility companies city electrical and water inspectors when I purposely cut the water and power off to my house by refusing to pay. They came knocking on the door. all I had to do was send them emails because they left their cards on the door. I just sent the electrical inspector and the water inspector an email that said, please contact your attorneys. Here's my lien number. They should be able to relieve your offices of any further services. They ain't bothered me since. Because they know the game. They know the name of the game. They know the name of the claim. They just want to see if we know it. And will we stand? But they also want us to pay, too. With our own money, create our own money so that we can buy goods and services off the retail shelves. Because it's easy to live with no power and water. For me, it was. Although it was a struggle, but it can be done. That's why I consider it easy. Anything that can be done is easy. Might not be easy for you. But like I said, I had to test everything to the extreme. I had to see everything that could be seen and experienced. I had to know it. And I know without a shadow of a doubt, nobody can move me off my share of the earth that I have claimed right here. I have a share of land. I have shelter. And the Pope has been forced to provide showers, soap, food bank food. Because the Pope knows that if he doesn't, then Mother Nature will spank him hard. And if you don't understand how that works, just type in Roger Elvick. Listen to the Roger Elvick recordings, and he'll give you a hint of how natural law works. That's the only reason why the Pope gives free food bank showers and soap. And in my area, because of the lien that I've put in, the Pope even provides free laundry. I'm doing all this in hopes to make it easier on you all. In other words, I purposely, quote unquote, died for you. I've done what no one else on this earth has done yet. I said, I have heard no reports from nobody on YouTube who has done what I have done with that commercial lien, the hammer that drives the nail in with one blow. Nobody can collect from me. Seen the tree bend in the wind. While you all are out there tending to your families, your jobs to keep yourselves going. I am a single man. I have no children, no woman. Because deep in my heart, I knew as a young man I had to prepare myself first for something. And make sure I took care of all things possible before I was to start any family whatsoever. Instincts told me deep, 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 deep down. And I followed those instincts. Although I have had some attempts at it. Like I said, the universe guided me because I had a purpose to be the first one on the planet to put the commercial lien fully to its fullest test so I could sit here on YouTube and say it can be done. Level, now that I've seen the commercial lien stand all up on its own and I've experienced it. Now I'm going to phase two. And that was all in my plans. Phase one. Don't pay for nothing. Let's see if that commercial lien actually works.
Oh, it does. Okay,
now phase two, as I see fit, I'm going to start implementing my own currency.
I've studied private maritime law with the best of the best. I've watched many seminars and DVDs that told me exactly what to do. But I could tell from listening to the best of the best who taught this information, I can tell he's never done what I've done. I can tell. I can tell that he's never stayed in the same house and faced all everything that can be thrown at him to stand his ground in that commercial lane. I can tell he's not done that. Although he was skilled enough to, once he's got himself into a position of realizing that his commercial lien works, he did go and live off the grid after the fact. But I could tell he never put himself through it right where he was at with the house that he had that was connected to power and connected to all the bills trying to collect from them. I can tell. Like I said, I'm the first one on this planet that has actually taken it to this extreme. Because there isn't a single report on YouTube from anybody. There's going to be more, because slowly but surely people are going to start to realize, damn, that YouTuber called Just Play, man. From the tribe of Judah, mixed with the native Iroquois, who were the settlers on the land known as New York, that's the capital of the whole world. Oh. This dude named Just Playman is the actual bloodline of King David and King Solomon and of the natives of the land of America, the Indian natives. Oh my God. And when that finally starts to sink into people, who I am and what I've accomplished, people are gonna start saying, Just Playman's family is the real royal family on the planet. stands for absolute, balanced, justice, representing the entire universe. Oh my God. When this finally sinks in and word gets around, and I got forever to wait around because I ain't going nowhere.
Like I said, I'm the first man, human, born for such a time. And I know who I am, and I don't go around trying to prove to everybody who I am. Although it is fun every now and then to let people know.
Hey!
Guess who I am? Just take a guess. I have fun with it, man. I ain't out to convince you. I ain't out to convince you. But I will speak the truth. Because that's all I know how to do. And that's all I want to do. And if I feel like sidestepping with you, I'll do that. For the sake of the peace. Keep this in mind. King Henry VIII and his wife came up with the idea to share all the resources with the people. And so what they would do is they would go out to the poor on the street and they would give them money and start to share the kingdom. But they realized all the people really wanted to do was just party and sex. So they came up with a better plan. That's what they called the Secure Party Creditor Trust System. And they said, okay, well, the universe will draw men into this trust system as the universe sees fit. So they created the system, and they put their trust in the universe for men to start funneling into it. King Henry VIII did this. With his wife. Plus he didn't have any sons, so he wanted to ensure an inheritance for his daughters. Looks like the picture stopped. I'm recording this, but I don't see myself moving on the picture. I'm using QuickTime to record this. So, anyway, I think I'll stop the video now. So, pretty much covered everything that I covered in the previous video. But, that's that. Enjoy.